dogs following the pack, all swallowed in their coats, with scarves of red tied round their throats, to keep their little hats from falling in the snow. And I turn round, and there you go, and Michael, you would fall, and turn the white snow red as strawberries in the summertime.
Good morning, everyone. I know this is a busy day for everyone. I'm Dave Rose, the Chief Public Information Officer for El Paso County. We do want to get started on schedule. For those of you who are just entering Centennial Hall, this is, of course, a very special day in El Paso County. This is the day that our newly elected and newly re-elected leaders and judges take the oath of office and begin their service. To honor this special occasion today, we're very privileged to have special music setting the tone for the event. On the dais behind me, the chamber choir from the Vanguard School, and we thank them so much for coming down and helping us to set the tone for this very, very special event. At this time, we would like to invite you to stand and remain standing as the flag of the United States of America is presented by the El Paso County Sheriff's Office Color Guard, and the Vanguard Chamber Choir leads us in the singing of our national anthem. At this time, I'd like to ask outgoing Commissioner Sally Clark to come to the podium and lead us in an invocation.
Thank you. I wanted to point out that the President of the United States at the time, Ronald Reagan, had some words to say for us, and our nation's motto, "In God We Trust," was not chosen lightly. It reflects a basic recognition that there is a divine authority in the universe to which this nation owes homage. Throughout our history, Americans have put their faith in God, and no one can doubt that we've been blessed for it. The earliest settlers of this land came in search of religious freedom. Landing on a desolate shoreline, they established a spiritual foundation that has served us ever since. It was the hard work of our people, the freedom they enjoyed, and their faith in God that built this country and made it the envy of the world. In all of our great cities and towns and counties, evidence of the faith of our people is found. Houses of worship of every denomination are among the oldest structures. While never willing to bow to a tyrant, our forefathers were always willing to get to their knees before God. And when catastrophe threatened, they turned to God for deliverance. When the harvest was bountiful, the first thought was thanksgiving to God. Prayer is today as powerful a force in our nation as it has ever been. We as a nation should never forget this source of strength. And while recognizing that the freedom to choose a godly path is the essence of liberty, as a nation, we cannot but hope that more of our citizens would, through prayer, come into a closer relationship with their Maker. Recognizing our great heritage, the Congress, by joint resolution approved April 17, 1952, and called upon the President to set aside a suitable day each year as a national day of prayer. So today we come to pray for our newly elected county officials, and I ask that those of you that would like to bow your heads. We come to honor you this day. We come to acknowledge our Almighty God, that you are the only one who can rightly lead and guide our country. Lord, we lift up prayer for our country. We ask that you would bless our country with your wisdom, your love, and your compassion. May we be a people who are pursuing you and your plans for us individually and corporately. Lord, we lift up our prayer for our leaders. Lord, we ask for blessings on our leaders. May these servants who are in positions of authority take that responsibility seriously and do their very best each day. May they realize their need for you and for your direction. May they hear your voice as they make their decisions, and may they follow your guidance. May they have a passion for people, for truth, and for righteousness. And Lord, we lift up prayers for our troops and those who put themselves in harm's way to keep our freedoms. Lord, we ask for blessings on our servicemen and women. We ask protection for all our men and women in uniform, both here and around the world. We're grateful for their service and their dedication to keeping our nation safe. We pray that you would keep them safe. We thank you for our blessings of life and liberty. May our country and our county and community continually show love and honor for you. May our dedication to you cause us to reach out to all other nations and people groups with a strong desire for peace and harmony to be displayed whenever possible. We ask all these things in the name of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you so much, Commissioner Clark. You may be seated. On behalf of the Board of County Commissioners, County Administrator Henry Yankowski, and all of us who work for you in El Paso County, a very special, heartfelt thanks to all of you who took time out of your busy schedules to come here this morning to witness our newly elected and newly re-elected county leaders and our judges of the 4th Judicial District taking the oath of office. Truth be told, I suspect that many of us should probably be home right now, organizing our neighbors into those grid search patterns that they talk about over at the sheriff's office. That's probably the only hope we'll ever have of seeing those trash cans again. Perhaps you noticed on your way in here, there appears to be a small army of county employees across the street. I could be mistaken, but I think they were trying to tie down a giant tarp over the Terry R. Harris Judicial Complex. When we began planning today's Oath of Office event, Chief Judge Gilbert Martinez told me that he wanted to get the judges sworn in first so that they could get over to their courtrooms by 9 a.m. Thanks to yesterday's storm, there's no need to rush. Last time I heard, they were hoping to get the courthouse open by noon and the jurors to show up at 1 o'clock this afternoon. I should take a few minutes to recognize, this is always a hazard at this event, but we'll try to recognize some of our dignitaries in the audience, and I apologize to those of you that I don't see. We certainly don't mean to leave anyone out, but I want to thank from our Colorado Springs City Council, President Merv Bennett, Tom Strand. I've seen in the group Jill Gabler, Andres Pico, Larry Bagley, all from Colorado Springs City Council, Chief of Staff Mr. Jeff Green, who is home in Centennial Hall, Bob Cope, Brett, we appreciate all of you coming down today. Former El Paso County Commissioners Jim Binsberg and Amy Lathan are in the audience today. I want to recognize former Colorado Springs Mayor Lionel Rivera, who has joined us here this morning. And of course, our countywide elected officials, Dan May, our district attorney, who swore in his office this morning. I think you had 79, did you?
That's right, 79 attorneys.
79 attorneys took the oath of office ahead of us this morning. Sheriff Bill Elder, I see up at the back there. Steve Schleicher, our county assessor, Thomas Mowell, our public trustee, and I suspect I have overlooked someone. I'm not sure I saw Mark Lauterman come in. There's Mark Lauterman at the back. Just as I look, there he shows up. Anyway, we want to thank all of you who've come today, and certainly all of you who've taken time out. This says a lot about your level of civic engagement and your participation in our community. The Honorable Judge Gilbert Martinez was born in Trinidad, Colorado. He grew up in the Denver area. He is a graduate of the University of Colorado and was appointed to serve as a district court judge in 1989. He was elevated to the position of Chief Presiding Judge for the 4th Judicial District in 1994, and that is a position that he holds today. Judge Martinez, if you would come forward. We have the judges first of the district court, followed by the judges of El Paso County Court, and we will begin with will Judge Robin Chittum please step forward to receive the oath of office.
And why don't we do this? I'm going to swear in all the district court judges at one time and then all the county court judges at one time. But before I do that, I would be remiss if I didn't tell you a little bit about my judges. And I say my judges, and I say that warmly. Other than the airport, that building across the street that we're trying to fix the roof on is the busiest building in El Paso County. We have more individuals come in and out of that building per day other than the airport. Sometimes, quite frankly, I think we even beat the airport. That means, if you saw how many district attorneys we have, that means El Paso County and Arapahoe County, quite frankly, are neck and neck in determining who has the most cases per judge, per county, per district in the state of Colorado. Sometimes we're higher than them, sometimes they're higher than us. That being said, we need to have a bench here in El Paso County that is hardworking, that understands people, that loves their job. And I'm here to tell you that here in El Paso County, we have a bench that is hardworking, loves their job, and they do a great job. I know I have a bias, but I think this is the best bench in the state of Colorado. With that, let me go ahead and swear in the district court judges. And that would be District Court Judge Chittum, District Court Judge Gross, District Court Judge Gilbert, District Court Judge Miller, and District Court Judge Prudick. And if I can have you all please raise your right hand. I do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States and of the state of Colorado, that I will faithfully and to the best of my ability perform the duties of the office upon which I'm about to enter, of the district court judge of the 4th Judicial District. Welcome and keep up the good work.
We have to get them to sign to take care of it.
And if I can have the El Paso County Court judges, that would be Judge Laura Findorf, Judge Carla Hansen, and Judge Daniel Wilson. County court judges seem to be taller than district court judges. If you'll raise your right hand. I do solemnly swear.
I do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And of the state of Colorado.
And of the state of Colorado.
That I will faithfully and to the best of my ability.
That I will faithfully and to the best of my ability.
Perform the duties of the office.
Perform the duties of the office.
Upon which I'm about to enter. Of County Court Judge
of
El Paso County, Colorado.
Of El Paso County, Colorado.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Judge Martinez. I knew I would overlook some people. I want to note County Clerk and Recorder Chuck Browerman, who is in the audience with us today. And I have yet to see him, though I think I met him in the hallway earlier. County Coroner Dr. Robert Bucks is in the audience today, and of course people are always dying to meet him. sorry about that. I also want to recognize Dirk Draper from the Colorado Springs Chamber of Commerce, Terry Sullivan from the Realtors Group, Mike Jorgensen, the Chamber of Commerce group as well, in the audience today. And again, we thank all of you for coming. We now turn to our newly elected and re-elected county commissioners. The first taking the oath of office today is Lohunas Gonzalez, Jr. He is representing County Commissioner District 4. This is... Representing Commissioner District 4, this is the seat formerly held by Commissioner Dennis Heisey. It encompasses the southern part of El Paso County, roughly from Highway 115 East, including Fort Carson, Security Widefield, and Fountain, and extending east out to the small community of Hanover. We welcome Lohunas Gonzalez to the podium, and if Judge Martinez will administer the oath of office.
I, Lohunas Gonzalez.
I, Lohunas Gonzalez, Jr.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
In the presence of the ever-living God.
In the presence of the ever-living God.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Colorado.
And the Constitution of the State of Colorado.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Perform the duties of County Commissioner.
Perform the duties of County Commissioner.
For El Paso County.
For El Paso County.
State of Colorado.
State of Colorado.
To the best of my skill and ability.
To the best of my skill and ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. For those of you who are wondering, Commissioner Gonzalez signs, Chief Judge Martinez signs, and the clerk to the board keeps it on file. Stan Vanderwerf, if you will come on down. Stan Vanderwerf is our newly elected commissioner representing District 3. This is the seat formerly held by Commissioner Sally Clark. This is the western side of El Paso County, generally from Palmer Lake to the north to the Fremont County line on the south, and from Cascade Avenue on the east to the Teller County line on the west. It includes Palmer Lake, portions of Colorado Springs, Manitou Springs, the Ute Pass area, and Green Mountain Falls.
Can you raise your right hand, please? I, Stan Vanderwerf.
I, Stan Vanderwerf.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
In the presence of the ever-living God.
In the presence of the ever-living God.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Colorado.
And the Constitution of the State of Colorado.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Perform the duties of County Commissioner.
Perform the duties of County Commissioner.
For El Paso County.
For El Paso County.
State of Colorado.
State of Colorado.
To the best of my skill and ability.
To the best of my skill and ability.
So help me God.
So help me God. Thank you very much.
And finally, Commissioner Mark Waller, if you will please come forward to take the oath of office. Commissioner Waller, who represents District 2, was sworn in this summer to fill the vacancy created when Commissioner Amy Lathan left office a few months early to accept a position in the private sector. Commissioner District 2 encompasses eastern El Paso County from Village 7 on the west, continuing east to the Elbert and Lincoln County lines. In addition to that, to the east side of Colorado Springs, it includes neighborhoods in part of Black Forest. It includes Cimarron Hills, Falcon, Peyton, Calhan, and Rama. I used to hear from former Commissioner Lathan as she complained that it took her all day to drive from one side of the district to the other. Fortunately, she eventually traded off that car.
I could do it in like a half hour.
Before I swear you in, you want to talk about the roof of the courthouse?
We're working on it already. I, Mark Waller.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
In the presence of the ever-living God.
In the presence of the ever-living God.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Colorado.
And the Constitution of the State of Colorado.
And that I will faithfully perform the duties.
And that I will faithfully perform the duties.
Of County Commissioner of El Paso County.
Of County Commissioner of El Paso County.
State of Colorado.
State of Colorado.
To the best of my skill and ability.
To the best of my skill and ability.
So help me God.
So help me God. Thanks, John. Appreciate it.
Mike, please.
And these folks can't go too far away because they got some work to do right away. A couple of weeks ago, before he went on vacation, a long overdue family vacation, I might add, the Board of County Commissioners approved a ceremonial proclamation honoring the service of outgoing District 4 Commissioner Dennis Heise. In just a few minutes, the board will open its regularly scheduled Tuesday meeting. And one of its first items of business will be the consideration of a similar proclamation honoring the service of outgoing District 3 Commissioner Sally Clark. That makes today's event, in military terms, something we might call a hail and farewell. After the presentation to Commissioner Clark, the board will recess, and we hope that all of you will be joining us for a brief reception outside the hearing hall at the top of the stairs. For those of you who would like to extend your best wishes to Commissioner Heise and Commissioner Clark, you can sign their respective traffic signs. We have a bit of a tradition here of having the county sign shop prepare something a bit tongue-in-cheek for outgoing office holders. They are located on a table at the top of the entryway area. This concludes our oath of office ceremony. Again, we invite you to stay for the opening of the Board of County Commissioners session, and then to stay with us for our reception outside in the hallway. Again, thank you so much for coming, and we are pretty much right on time. The judges will appreciate that, although they have no place to go.